nice. He really meant that. When you reject the least of these, you reject him. Why? Because he became the least of these. And we did reject him. And so when we love the poor, guess who we're actually loving? We're loving Jesus. When we make policies that benefit the most oppressed and vulnerable in society, what are we actually doing? Who are we loving when we advocate for those types of policies? For just policies that benefit all people, regardless of color, culture, and class. Who are we loving when we stand up for those things? We're loving Jesus. Who are we putting on display when we forgive our neighbors, when we love our enemies? When we actually, someone says, we have to fight for our rights. No, Jesus laid down his rights. When we lay down our rights for the sake of the common good, when we lay down our rights for the sake of others, even our enemies, that's how redemption is birthed. That's how restoration comes about in the wounds as we love. This is what Jesus did. And this is what happens as we believe this. As we enter into it, as we realize our union with him, that is who we are in Christ. We are new creations. The old is gone, the new has come. And all this is from God, who was reconciling humanity to himself. And now he invites us to be what? To be ambassadors of what? Of reconciliation. We get to be part of it. We get to be ambassadors now. And I don't know about you, but I want to. I want to be able to say in 20 years or 30 years that I was a restorer of streets with dwelling, that I spent my life on what really mattered. That I didn't spend my life on myself. That I didn't take God's blessing and use it to bless myself, but I took God's blessing and used it to bless others. Because that's unfortunately what's happening, right? Our country has been blessed. I mean, we're the richest country in the world right now. We are. Guess what else we do? We export 70% of the world's pornography. What else do we do? We kill a whole lot of babies. What else do we do? We segregate our communities. We marginalize the poor. We figure out ways to somehow push them out of our lives. What else do we do? We build bigger and bigger jails, and we just arrest people, especially the people within the lower class, for petty things, and we lock them up, get them out of our communities because they inconvenience us a whole lot. And some of them are criminals. Yes, there's criminals that need to be in jail. But there's a lot of injustice. And as Americans, as people here in Atlanta, I think Jesus is glorified when we step in and we use our voices, we use our resources to advocate for the poor. On a corporate level, a personal level too, by doing these very things, by actually sharing life with people different than us, by sharing life with people from a different ethnicity or different class or different culture, by actually going into someone else's home or having them in our home and being with people the way Jesus was with us. And this is not easy, right? I'm going to finish up here. This is actually impossible. Once again, we come back to a place where we have to say, I surrender, God. Like, I need you. I need your spirit, Jesus. At the end of the day, our goal can't be to be one of these pictures on the wall someday. Our goal's got to be to walk with Jesus and to hear him say, well done, good faithful servant. And we can't fight this. We can't fight this alone. We need the Holy Spirit, and we need each other.